military weapons.
Welcome back and thank you for watching. Make sure that you're subscribed and have your notifications turned on for more in the future. The Boeing Sikorsky RAH-66 Comanche is an advanced five-blade armed reconnaissance and attack helicopter that's designed for the United States Army. The program was canceled in February of 2004 as the U.S. Army announced they had decided to terminate all work on the Comanche program. Now, at the time, it was stated that the Army had determined a number of upgrades would be necessary for the RAH-66 to be capable of surviving on the battlefield in the face of current anti-aircraft threats. However, they also insisted to decide to redirect the bulk of their funding for rotary development toward the renovation of its existing helicopter fleet of attack, utility, and reconnaissance aircrafts. Specifically, the Army also had plans to reuse the funds allocated to the Comanche program in order to speed up the development of an unmanned aerial vehicle, or a UAV, which could also perform the scouting role intended for the vehicle itself. What's interesting to know is that the Boeing Sikorsky RAH-66 Comanche would have functioned as a stealth helicopter, incorporating a number of different techniques and technologies in order to reduce its radar cross-section, or RCS, along with other areas of visibility and detection. It was specifically tailored to the role of armed scout in order to replace the U.S. Army's OH-58D Kiowa Warrior, which is an upgraded version of a Vietnam War-era observation helicopter. The RAH-66 was powered by a pair of LHTEC T-800 turboshaft engines, each capable of supplying 1,563 horsepower to its engine. The RAH-66's fuselage was 43 feet long, composed of composite materials, and was designed to be capable of fitting more readily onto transport ships, while also enabling the Comanche to be more rapidly deployed to flashpoints and other rapidly developing situations. However, in the event of strategic transport assets not being available, the rotorcraft's ferry range of 1200 nmi would have allowed it to fly itself to battlefields overseas on its own. The Comanche was known to be equipped with sophisticated avionics, which included navigation and detection systems, which would have also enabled operations during nighttime and within challenging weather conditions. Its primary mission was to scout around using its advanced sensors, attempting to find and designate targets for attack helicopters, such as the AH-64 Apache, in order to strike. The Comanche was furnished with a digital fly-by-wire flight control system. Each of the two crew members were then provided with a pair of LCD multifunctional displays, which would have functioned in addition to the helmet integrated display and sight system worn by the crew. Of its general characteristics, it featured a crew of two with a length of 14.28 meters. The rotor diameter was 11.9 meters, and the height was 3.37 meters. Its rotor systems had 5-bladed main rotors with 8-bladed fan-in-fin anti-torque system. The power plant featured two LHTEC T-800 LHT-801 turboshaft with 1,165 kilowatts each. Its performance showed a maximum speed of 324 kilometers per hour, with the cruise speed set at 306. The range could go 485 kilometers on its internal fuel, and the combat radius was 278 kilometers on internal fuel. The ferry range was 2,220 kilometers with an endurance of 2.5 hours. The service ceiling was 4,566 meters with a rate of climb at 4.55 meters per second. The armament featured a 20mm XM301 three-barrel Gatling-style cannon that was mounted in a turreted gun system with a capability of 500 rounds. Its internal base had six AGM-114 Hellfire air-to-ground missiles, or it could come equipped with 12 AIM-92 Stinger air-to-air missiles, or 24 2.75 Hydra-70 air-to-ground rockets. Options included stub wings with 8 Hellfires, 16 Stingers, or 56 Hydra 70 rockets. Thanks for watching, and as always, make sure that you're subscribed to our channel and have your notifications turned on for more in the future. Leave a like and a comment below, and we'll see you next time.